Hi, welcome to the eJenn Solutions YouTube channel where we help make your business social media just a little bit easier. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a QR code for a link. Yes, and not only that, at the end of this video, I'm going to give you so many good ideas for how you can use QR codes that you're just going to be subscribing like a madman. All right, let's get going to the desktop so I can show you how to do it. Okay, so here we are at my favorite QR code generator, which you can use to generate a QR code that will send someone to a website link. Now, what I love about this program, and I'll move myself here, program or this company is called QR Tiger. And I'm not an affiliate. I use them. I do have a referral link, which I think you get some money off and I get some money off. We use this for our business. And I do have a paid version for us, but there is a free version. So if you're looking just to do 1 to 3 QR codes, this is a great option for you. Now, the first thing I want to do is talk to you about the difference between what is a static QR code and what is a dynamic QR code. A static QR code means that you create the QR code, you put in the link, and basically freeze frame it. It's done. There, you can never change the URL that you used or the website link that you used for that QR code. A dynamic QR code means that yes, you created it with that link, but on the back end, you can change that link around. How would this work? Well, let's say you're doing a QR code for a limited time offer, something that's going to expire. So you create the scan or you create the QR code that people can scan, and that would take them to a place where they could download a coupon or they would get to a landing page that has that offer. Once that offer ends, then you want to change that link because obviously it's no longer an offer or a launch or whatever it is. You want to change it and redirect them to another page, possibly your main page of your website. So that's really why a dynamic QR code is important. The second thing that's important for is if you're using print. Now, for a digital world, we can just create new ones and change QR codes out. But if you're using a QR code for print, you might, especially if you're spending a lot of money, you might want to make sure you have that ability to change that link in the background at a later date. So it's really important, especially for using QR codes in print, you want to have that dynamic QR code or ability to edit the URL or the website link in the background. Okay, so here's how we're going to do it. But we're going to go ahead and put in a URL or a website link right in here, and then we're going to go ahead and generate our code. So I'm, of course, assuming that you've already set up your account with QR Tiger, but this is how that's going to work. Now, this is the cool part. I get so excited because there's so many free features, but also there's so many ways that you can customize this. So the first thing you get to do is choose your pattern, and this would be the pattern or how things look inside that QR code. And so they give you a couple options here, taking a little longer. You can kind of see how that changes, which is really cool. So you can kind of get a feel or a look that you want. And then you can choose the eyes. And the eyes are these three corner boxes here, and they give you a lot of different types of looks that you can go for. So let's say you want just a circle and a square. Now this is the part where it gets fun. You can actually upload your logo, and that logo is going to show up right in the middle. But let's say you want to put on your card, or you want to put in your book, or you want to put on your business card, you want people to follow you on Instagram. Well, you can put in a logo, or as they have here, pre-made one that has the Instagram logo. Now people are going to know if they scan that, they're going to get right to your Instagram. But we're going to tell them a little bit more, but this is a good start, right? Great information here, or great feature here to be able to change and use your brand colors. So it's very important that you have your branding together and you know your colors so that you can add it. You can see here how to change it. That's super ugly. I'm just playing around with this so we can see how it looks. All right, so it's gonna figure that out here. We'll wait a few minutes. Oof, I don't even want to sit here and watch this. Let's not do that. Let's not say we did, right? That did not look good. All right. So while we let this change, we're going to keep that. We can also choose a frame. I do like this a lot because we can kind of get, depending on where you're putting it in print or however, just basically how you want this frame to look. You don't even have to have a frame. You can just have the QR code. Perhaps you're putting it into something where you already created the frame and everything, but you can see here how this looks kind of cool. And has your colors. It has, of course, the Instagram logo. And you can also change this to whatever you want. And along with changing the call to action here, although I would probably leave the word scan me in there, you can also change the logo or the font, so you can kind of get that desired look, like something similar. Templates, so these are optional. So I said I was going to tell you a couple of ways that you could use QR codes. Well, of course you can have them follow you on Pinterest, but you can also download it to like a white paper, a PDF, maybe it's a proposal, an Excel sheet. So if you've got some type of an Excel sheet that you want to give people, you can actually do that. Let's take a look so you can see that. And of course, a Word doc. So these are really cool ways and different ideas. Instead of just sending people to a website link, you can generate a QR code that'll send people to a Word doc, a PDF. You can generate a QR code for an Excel sheet. So just a couple of ideas that you might want to consider using a QR code. Now, the pricing, of course, the pricing, you're going to get more if you pay. You, in the free version, you get 3 QR codes or dynamic QR codes. You get 12 if you pay. And of course, as I said earlier, Canva, you can integrate this so easily into Canva. Stay tuned, I'm going to do a video on that. There you are. That's super easy. Once you have that built, all you have to do is download that, and then you can integrate that into your design through Canva or, of course, print or anything else that you're using. All right, so just a few ideas that you can use your QR codes for. Don't forget, of course, we know you can use your QR code to link to a PDF. You can use your QR code to link to a website. You can use your QR code to link to any numerous things, your social sites, blah, blah, blah. But here are some things you might not have thought about. You can actually, you can do it through QR Tiger. You can actually have a QR code go right to your Google form. Brilliant. You can have it go right to a MP3 file so that they can easily listen to your sound if you're a musician or artist. You can link a QR code to your Wi-Fi information so that once you scan that, they can automatically automatically sign on or log into your Wi-Fi. You can even put the password in there. It's brilliant. And that's all through QR Tiger that you can do that. But then, of course, if you're a speaker, you might want to put a QR code on your presentations. Again, the Google form, fill out this information. We'll have you sign up for our newsletter. There's just endless ideas for where you want to use it. Here is where you don't want to use it or you want to be careful using it. Remember, people use their mobile devices. Where are people mostly watching whatever it is that they're looking at on social media or possibly videos? Typically, it's their mobile phone. So unless it is on the big screen or on TV, you want to be careful. They can't obviously use their phone to scan a QR code if they are already on their phone. So think about your demographic. Where are they going to be viewing this QR code and will they easily have access to scan it? So those are my words of advice. I hope this has helped you out. If you are a subscriber, thank you so much, and I will see you again in the next video.
Be right back. Yeah, sunny days, no clouds in the sky, about to get away, feels like it's